from the hood. Weighing in at 215 pounds, he is Militant Mark Magnum. A decided change in attitude for Militant Mark Magnum, JC. Ever since hitting Jackson Breeze right in the mouth at Origins 2, he has been a changed man.
Not a lot of attitudes changing around here. Jay West, Jonah Wales, Mark Magnum. I wouldn't say that the attitude of Hannibal Rex, though, has changed that much since he's been here in FTW. Would you, Mooney?
He is his own man at all times, 24-7, 365. Oh, look at that. Kissing babies.
Hey, they're my babies, so shut up.
Wait for it. There it is.
Really warmed up to those streamers, Mooney. Wasn't always so much of a fan, you know?
Oh, it's a taste the rainbow moment here at the FGW Arena in Hamilton, Ohio. Glad everybody can be with us for Friday Night Fury. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, every Friday night, we are here for Friday Night Fury. And there's so much you don't see on Shockwave that you can see here. You can interact with the superstars of Future Great Wrestling at intermission, take pictures, get autographs, buy all the t-shirts, and really get to know the superstars. Also, we've got the 50-50 Split the Pot raffle and matches you may never see on our official YouTube channel.
And this match about to be underway, Mark Magnum and Hannibal Rex. Hannibal Rex, a little tipsy for the match tonight. You know, Hannibal Rex once said that he's not an alcoholic, he's a drunk. Alcoholics go to meetings.
That's right.
You know, he uses that, we'll say, that liquid encouragement to really pull out all the stops and put all of his rage and aggression out on his opponents.
It centers him. He finds his inner chaw.
Yeah.
With a few stiff drinks.
A lot better than Jay West ever did, that's for sure.
The love of decency does not abide within you, my friend. I thought we were past all that. And Hannibal Rex starting this match off with a display of power, pushing Magnum down to the mat, collar and elbow tie up, center of the ring. Magnum, again, knocked down on his keister.
Yeah, look at that. Hannibal Rex looking good. It's that liquid encouragement, Mooney.
Probably has a little bit to do with those tacos. And Magnum went behind the big man, went for a headlock, but couldn't secure it, and shoulder tackle, no effect. And again, Magnum, an exercise in futility. What's the veteran going to do, JC? What do you do in this situation?
Well, he's not going to try it again. He's going to punch him in the face. To answer your question.
Magnum.
Spinning heel kick.
Put that one right in the sternum. And Rex has decided to take a timeout.
Take a little stroll around the ring, get your bearings about you. Nothing wrong with that. Oh, no, a little bit of, more of that liquid encouragement out of that Taco Bell bag.
I think Hannibal Rex actually appeared on a Taco
Bell. No, wait. No.
I think he actually appeared on a Taco Bell sauce packet. His picture appeared briefly.
Huh. Hold on now.
Magnum catches Rex from behind. Oh, yo quiero Taco Bell.
That Friday night stroll around the ring cut short by Mark Magnum, who's now delivering chops across the chest of Hannibal Rex right here inches away from the people.
Rex back in the ring, and now Magnum looking to take control.
Sidewalk slam.
And this is a crucial one-on-one contest tonight. The winner will move up in the rankings. Both men needing a victory, coming out of Origins 2. Of course, Magnum lost to West at Origins 2. Rex also not a successful showing at Origins, our one-year anniversary show.
That's the great thing about FGW. There's always next week. And right now, Animal Rex, he's got this match going at his pace.
And Magnum at one point looked like he was going to take over on Rex, but now the size advantage seems to have cut the veteran off. And Rex, Irish whip into the corner. And the dive bar daddy taking his time getting there. Didn't rush in, JC.
And casually struts over there to Mark Magnum to deliver some elbows.
Taking his time, making every shot count. And Rex.
Ask me, he might be a little bit too casual right now. That is Mark Magnum in there. But what a suplex.
I think he's got Magnum right where he wants him. He is in control of this matchup here on Friday Night Fury.
I guess you can't argue with those results. And there's the two count. Got that knee over the chest of Mark Magnum.
Stomp to the inner thigh. Trying to get that quad to Charlie Horse and take out any kind of leverage Magnum might have.
Trying to flat that tire of Mark Magnum.
Coughing, looking for air.
Look at this.
Oh, wow.
Just stomp his chest into the middle of the ring.
Nothing fancy about that, JC. There's no putting lipstick on that pig.
Now look at this now. This might be the finishing move. At least it should be. He's got Mark Magnum right where he wants him. Whip into the far corner. What's Animal Rex got in mind?
Oh, he changed his strategy and that time ran into the boot.
Rudy, it was too much.
Oh,
oh no.
Oh, 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 oh. Wow. That's got to be. Oh, oh, I don't believe it. Magnum kicked out of that. Oh.
Oh, my God. He almost knocked his head over here on our table.
Oh, wow. Magnum, if his eyes were open, he'd be staring at the lights, but he is semi-conscious, JC.
I was just about to say that maybe Hannibal Rex needs to rethink his strategy, but you cannot argue with those results. I stand corrected. That doesn't happen often, you know.
No, not at all. And now Hannibal Rex asserting himself. Magnum is in trouble. He is fatigued.
Oh, my God, that kick.
Not a lot behind those right hands, and Magnum is struggling.
Oh no, look at this now. He's draped over that top rope. Let me go over the Hannibal hangover. There it is.
He didn't quite get all that, JC. And that may be a reprieve. Magnum may have caught a lucky break. Oh, and you're not going to beat Magnum.
This is not wise.
No, you're not going to. No.
He should have put all of his weight across his chest. He maybe could have got it there. I don't know. We never will, but not with a pen like that.
And his judgment may be impaired by what's inside that Taco Bell bag. And now, just demolishing the left elbow of Mark Magnum.
Hold on. This might be a serious situation.
And Glenn Young is checking on Magnum. He may have broke the elbow. Oh, and Rex laying the bad mouth on Magnum. And
yeah, elbow, shoulder situation, something to do with the arm of Mark Magnum.
And I think Young is going to let this match continue, but for how long?
Oh, no.
Oh, the torque on that elbow.
A hammerlock with an assist from the ropes. from Hannibal Rex.
And this is where the referee's going to have to assert some judgment and maybe step in and call this.
And Mark Magnum might want to live to fight another day. Hannibal Rex is not going to let up until he's told to by the official, and you can't blame him for that.
Oh, Magnum was hung up, and he just had his head sandwiched between the boot of Rex and the turnbuckle.
Sick, sadistic punishment from Hannibal Rex. Oh, my DDT, spiking Mark Magnum. Hannibal Rex, he needs to show some urgency. A win over Mark Magnum will be huge, but he kicks out. Mark Magnum, he kicks out. A little bit of frustration now. The blood boiling a little bit of Hannibal Rex.
And that time he took the pinfall serious, and I think that's what's got him frustrated. That time he was taking it serious. That time he thought he had him. He was going to try and get this over with. And Magnum showing a lot of determination, a lot of grit. And now the right arm. And Magnum, both arms now have been damaged by Hannibal Rex.
Especially that left arm. You still see Mark Magnum grabbing at it.
Incredible fight within this man.
He's begging for more.
And he got it. Big clothesline.
Hannibal Rex almost looks perplexed as to what to do next. He drops a leg across the throat, shoulders down, leg draped over the larynx.
He didn't hook the leg, JC. He didn't have enough weight distributed over the shoulders and chest. And Magnum is one tough customer.
Yeah, these covers from Hannibal Rex leaving something to be desired. But the aggression, Mooney. The great punishment.
Call, great call, JC. If there's a hole in Rex's game, it's right there in the pinfalls, or the pin attempts, excuse me.
It's almost like he just, like maybe he doesn't want Mark Magnum to be down for the three. Maybe he wants to just continue to punish and thrive off of the absolute barbaric
and Magnum,
show of, oh my God, look at his neck.
It should have been a rope break, but Glenn Young didn't see Magnum's foot on the bottom rope, and Rex wisely pulled him to the center of the ring.
And Mooney, this is a man driving his knee into the back of another man's neck, stretching his arm backwards.
And the
Mark
fans,
Magnum fighting through it.
You hear the fans, JC. They are solidly behind Magnum. Headbutt and another. Maybe the only extremity working right now. Oh, goodness. Forearm right to the jaw, JC.
How impressive has Hannibal Rex been in this match?
As we said before, a win here gets you one step closer to the FGW champion, undefeated Sexy Sean Casey. And you got to believe Brian Levick is in the back watching this matchup, paying attention to what's happening here.
Mark Magnum, an FGW original, Hannibal Rex, relatively new to FGW. Neither one of these men ever been FGW champion. And like you said, Mooney, a huge chance to showcase what you've got in this ring here tonight.
Every match in FGW counts for something.
Oh, a haymaker.
Rex is stunned. Blockbuster. Got all of that one, Flash.
And there we go, a cover from Mark Magnum, a hook to the leg.
And Rex getting the right shoulder up, up. Whoa, wait a minute.
What Jackson is, Breeze.
Now we've got Jackson Breeze here at ringside.
I'm gonna bring Jackson Breeze out here.
And wherever he goes, controversy follows. He is the catalyst for Sexy Sean Casey's win at Origins 2 for the FGW Championship over Mitch Magnus. And Jackson Breeze has just handed something to Hannibal. He handed a flax a flask full of whiskey.
I think his mouth was a little dry, Mooney.
Rex saying, hey, that's good stuff. Oh, that backfired on Jackson Breeze.
Revolver from Mark Magnum.
And here is your winner, Militant Mark Magnum.
Hey, look at this.
And here come the hired goons of Jackson Breeze, the general manager and matchmaker of Future Great Wrestling. That's former FGW champion Trice and the made man.
Oh no.
The made man, Gino DiCapo.
European uppercut to Mark Magnum. Hannibal Rex limping away as this thug like assault on Mark Magnum from DiCapo and Trice, orchestrated by Jackson Breeze.
That was a well-dressed waylay of Militant Mark Magnum.
Certainly one way to describe it.
He showed a lot of courage against a coward and his hired goons.
Jackson Breeze asking for a mic. Somebody gonna need a mic.
All right.
Stay back.
I see what you're up to, Jackson, and that's fine. I expected it. But what I propose for next week, I don't care if it's you, Trice, or this no-name nobody in a tacky tie. I don't care which one of you it is. One of y'all's getting your ass kicked next week. Believe me.
Statement made by Mark Magnum after that beatdown. We'll see what comes of that next week. We gotta go to commercial break. Stay with us though, we have a lot more action to come here on Shockwave.